Good morning, students. How are you? Hope you are staying safe at your home. So, in the previous video session, we have discussed about the difference between stocks and flows, gross investment, net investment, and the concept of depreciation. In today's video session, we will discuss about the four sectors of an economy and intersectoral flows, that is real flow and money flow. So before starting this topic, we have to discuss about the four sectors of an economy, that is household sector, producer sector, government sector, and external sector. External sector is also known as rest of the world sector. So what is household sector? Household sector is that sector in which consumer lives, in which we live. So basically, the household sector is the owners of factors of production. So there are four factors of production: land, labor, capital, entrepreneur. So all these four factors of production comes from the household sector. So we can say that household sector is the owner of the factors of production. Next comes producer sector. Producer sector is the sector who produces or manufactures the goods and services with the help of factors of production which are being provided by the household sector. So producer sector is the sector who produces or manufactures the goods and services. Then comes government sector. Government sector is that sector who works for the social welfare of the people or a charity of the poor people. That is government sector. And government sector also works for the developmental activities of the nation. Fourth sector comes the external sector. External sector is the sector with whom we do the export and import. So that what we call it as a external sector. So these are the brief description of the four sectors of an economy: household, producer, government, and external sector. Next come intersectoral flows. So basically, intersectoral flows is of two types, that is real flow and money flow. Basically, the intersectoral flows is of two types, that is real flow and money flow. Real flow is that flow in which there is no involvement of money. Real flow is that flow in which there is no involvement of money, whereas money flow is the flow in which there is involvement of money. So let's start with the real flow. So basically, we will discuss about the intersectoral flows between two sectors, that is household sector and producer sector. Household sector and producer sector. So as I have told you, that is real flow is that flow in which there is no involvement of money. So household sector are the owners of factors of production. Household sector are the owners of factors of production. So they are providing the factor services to the producer sector. That they are providing the factor services to the producer sector. Factor services means land, labor, capital, and entrepreneur. Next comes, then producer sector is providing the goods and services to the household sector. Producer sector in return to the household sector is providing goods and services for rendering the factor services. So here it is called a, we call it as a real flow. Real flow is that flow in which there is no involvement of money. Then comes money flow. So again, we have two sectors, that is household sector and producer sector. So household sector is giving producer sector the payment for goods and services. Household sector is giving payment to the producer for goods and services. On the other hand, producer sector is giving payment of factor services to the household sector, which has been provided by the household sector to the producer sector, that is rent for land, wages for labor, interest for capital and profit for entrepreneur. So in this there is involvement of money, so we can call it as money flow. Money flow is that flow in which there is involvement of money. So there is one question that real flows and money flows are opposite to each other. Real flows and money flows are opposite to each other. Now let's see how they are opposite to each other. That is household sector and producer sector. Household sector is providing producer sector, that is factor services. Household sector producer sector को क्या दे रहा है? Factor services. और उसके बदले producer sector household sector को क्या दे रहा है? Goods and services. Then producer sector is paying household sector for what? That is payment for factor services. Then household sector is paying producer sector of what? That is payment for goods and services. So diagrammatically you can see that if real flows are moving clockwise, then money flows are moving anti-clockwise. So both flows, that is real flows and money flows, are opposite to each other. It is also called two-sectoral flow. So what is the importance of studying this intersectoral flows? It helps us in estimation of national income. जब भी हमें national income calculate करनी है, तो estimation में हमें ये बहुत ज़्यादा help करता है. It helps in calculating national income. It helps in estimation of national income. Second, it tells us about that how the different sectors are interdependent on each other. That how household sector is dependent upon producer sector and how producer sector is dependent on household sector. So with this we are completing our second chapter, that is some basic concepts of macroeconomics. So please watch this video very carefully and we will sort out your queries in the next Zoom meeting session. Thanks and have a nice day.